88. That's when their Russian superstar Pavel Bure was leading the Soviets to an Olympic gold medal. With the Canucks, Bure is after another prize, and Bure is doing all he can. He's got 11 goals in his last 10 games. Tied at one in the second, Bure blows it by Van Beesbrouck, his 37th of the year. Rangers come back, though. Phil Bourque on the rush with some skating room, takes advantage and finds Mike Gartner in front. Gartner's 27th of the year with tied at two. In the third, the Canucks on a two-on-one. Adams to Bure, misses one, scores on the second try. Vancouver leads by one, 3-2. Ah, time to go back in time. Some memories for goalie Kirk McLean. Thinking back to last February 17th when Vancouver played the Rangers and Turcotte beat him in the final second with a tying goal for the Rangers. Back to the present now. Canucks clinging to a one-goal lead, 12 seconds left. Mike Gartner ends up with it in front of the net. Sends it right through McLean's legs. We're tied at three again. Oh, no, not again for Kirk McLean. The Rangers love it, but Kirk McLean is a bit stunned. To overtime we go, and that's where this man comes up big. Maybe one of his biggest saves of the year against Bure. The stop in overtime. Now, time running out. Messier on a two-on-one. He shoots. McLean the save. Oh, wait a minute. Is it a goal? There are two pucks out on the ice. Messier yelling at the bozo in the stands who threw the puck out on the ice. Take another look. McLean making the save on Messier, and someone who obviously has no life decides to throw another puck out on the ice. Bottom line, confusion, no goal allowed. The game ends in a 3-3 tie. One of those things where you say, only in New York. The Boston netminder chose retirement instead of a demotion to the Bruins minor league team in Providence. One guy who's probably thinking of retirement is this guy. Referee Paul Stewart gets flattened in the Blues-Wings game. This game was scoreless in the first until Garth Butcher scores his first goal in 13 games. His old Leaf mates in the second. We're tied at one. Jablonski with a save for Tampa, and Mark Bure catches up with it and then sends it a long way to Bradley, who's just hanging out there at the blue line, in on alone on Fuhr, and doesn't miss. 32 goals for Bradley, 2-1 Lightning. Bradley would hurt his team, though. He takes a swipe at Gilmore and takes a stupid penalty. Toronto takes advantage on the power play with a John Cullen goal. We're tied at two. Terry Crisp adding up the penalty minutes. Too many. Maple Leafs, two-man advantage. Borshevsky with one of his two goals on the night. Yes, Basil McRae showing us they don't make Zambonis the way they used to. Borshevsky, two goals. Glenn Anderson, a big night for Toronto, a goal and three assists. And all four of Toronto's tallies were power play goals. Mike?
With four teams in the NFL...
Okay, I want half-hour specials about Cindy. I want hour-long rockumentaries about Cindy. I want Cindy unplugged. I want acoustic Cindy. I want long, drawn-out, slow-motion shots of Cindy walking, Cindy sleeping, Cindy eating an Eskimo pie naked on the roof of the Empire State Building, okay? I want to change the House of Style to the House of Cindy. Not MTV, CTV. No rock, no promos, no Richard Gere, just me and Cindy, okay? I think you hear me knocking, Richard, and I think I'm coming in, and I got a box full of Eskimo pies with me.
Game winless streak, but Tuesday night they had to deal with those pesky Ottawa Senators looking for a two-game winning streak. Their first two-game winning streak. To the Ottawa Civic Center we go. Wayne Gretzky named to the NHL All-Star team, just like the networks wanted him to be. But early, Ottawa jumped out on top. Mark Lamb with a wrist shot, and he scores. 1-0 Senators. Second period, 2-0 Ottawa. Uh-oh. But no. Paul Coffey to Rob Blake. That made it 2-1. And then Luke Robitaille, the man who was captain until Gretzky came back. Perfect pass to Marty McSorley, who makes no mistake. We're tied at 2, and here come the Kings. Third period, still 2-2. John McIntyre shoots, deflecting off the skate of Warren Reichel. If it's not intentional, it counts. It's not intentional. He didn't kick that in. It counts. And the Kings win it by a score of 3-2. Gretzky had an assist. The Kings had 25 shots the second period alone. Canucks continuing their Eastern road swing Tuesday night in New Jersey. Now, Stefan Richey and Bobby Holik on the Jersey bench saying, look, I'm going to give you a 90-degree pass off the defenseman's stick like this, and you'll put it past Kay Whitmore. And Bobby Holik says, yes, I will. And he scores his third goal in the last three games. Peter Nedved, the breakaway here for Vancouver, but Chris Terreri stones him in the slot. Terreri had 28 saves. With 29 seconds to go in the game, Alexander Cimak beating Billy Guerin, the kid from Boston College. Tips it home with the winning goal. Devils win 3-2. Guerin's fifth goal. Devils 4-0-2 in their last six. If they ever get it together, look out. With this win, they jump over the Rangers in the third place in the Patrick Division. Calgary Flames on Long Island.
Hawks. Dave Larmer tees up a long shot, deflecting off the crossbar.
Well, I guess it did. The goalie's best friend. Definitely worth another look. John Casey, the Minnesota goalie, never saw it, friends. First period, Dirk Graham unloading on Mike Modano, not once, not twice, but three times. Stuart Gammon breaking away from Minnesota. Belfort comes out too far. Minnesota leads 1-0, but Brent Sutter answers right back between the pads for Chicago. We're tied at 1. Third period, Greg Gilbert's long slapper stunning John Casey. Gilbert's 8th, 2-1 Chicago. Moments later, Steve Larmer. I tell you, there's not a more consistent performer in the NHL. Every year for 11, 12 years, 80 points or better. Chicago wins it 3-1. Goalie Ed Belfour now 12-5-1 lifetime against the Stars. The Hawks on top by 5 in the Norris Division. And Attabat Bruins were back, by the way, Chris. They drew 56 minutes in penalties, including two game misconducts. That's what we like to see. Bruins win for the first time this year over Buffalo. Winnipeg over San Jose, but 4-1. Alexei Zhamnov scored twice, and Timu Solani had a goal and two assists. The Jets win their fourth straight. In fact, the Winnipeg Jets, one of the hottest teams in the NHL, 7-1-1 in their
lifetime. Goals and 16 assists.
And college.
Zombo, he was telling me tonight. Good move there by Dallas Drake to go around Beers up the sidewall. And Drake not able to get to the loose puck before Bergeron chopped it away. With Isobart parked on the far side, looking for a loose puck. He's knocked into the net.
It was McCray that shot it, but Tucker may have deflected it, and it doesn't take long for the Boo Birds to come out as the Lightning have struck first, and they lead it 1-0.
That puck did hit Sean Tucker. I think it caught the handle of his hockey stick and redirected down towards the ice and changed directions on Cheveldae. There's not much he can do about it here. The loose puck comes off the boards right to Beers. That's a smart little play to get it to McCray, and there's the deflection by Tucker right there down underneath the pad of Tim Cheveldae. He has absolutely no chance on the play. And there's the play right there from Beers that really made it happen. That and the puck coming off the boards. There's the deflection. Good look at it right there. And it's 1-0 Tampa.
Seventh of the year from Tucker, from McCray and Beers, a 3:47. Again, just the second shot on goal in the Red Wings.
And a breakaway for Tucker, and he never did get full control until he was past the goal line, and Cheveldae able to stop it from a very difficult angle. And John Tucker, who was a big goal scorer in junior.
Oh, he's got to be hot at himself for what he did here.
Maybe one too many moves. Maybe.
Red Wings get crossed up here. They get too many guys together in the middle. Tucker comes out of nowhere, just grabs a loose puck, and he really deked himself right out of position. No way he can score from over there. He's behind the red line, and Chevalier's on both knees. He just lost control of it. That's not like John Tucker to do something like that. He's shaking his head.
Draw back to Rieke. His shot stopped by Cheveldae. Now Racine will start it back for the Red Wings. Still have a minute 20 on this power play. Trailing the Lightning 1-0. Cross-ice pass, Probert. Drops it back for Sheppard. Sheppard to Probert in the corner. Probert looking back along the boards for Sheppard. Sheppard able to work it loose for Probert. The referee, Mike Magoo, just Bradley. Rolls it back out in front, goes all the way to the line. Beers tees it up. Hip shot stopped by Cheveldae. And the puck cleared out to center ice. Fedorov takes a hit. Drake tried to drop it back quickly for Mark Howe, who was breaking into the clear. Pass didn't get through. Red Wings get it back. Here's Isobart. Gives it off to Mark Howe. He is checked by Tucker. Now Basil McCray had it tipped away by Isobart. Isobart in the corner. Rolls it right in front. Redirected by Drake, wide of the net. Now Fedorov gets to the loose puck. Sergei in front for Isobart. He lifted it right over the top of the net, and he had some room. And back come the Lightning. Tucker one-on-one against Chiasson. Chiasson forces him back. Tucker cross ice, intercepted by Dallas Drake. Drake gives it off to Iserman. Cheveldae, and he hangs on. So the Lightning had the only goal at 3:47. Tucker seventh from McCray and Beers. On it, Trobit just over the top of the net. Iserman's pass deflects off of Mikhail Anderson, and Tagli trying to fight off Ray Shepard's check, throws it across the Red Wing zone, and the puck is cleared by Carson. Doug Crossman plays it ahead. Cole has it there. Robert dumps him in front of the Red Wing bench. Cheveldae out of the net. Wristing it out to center ice. He didn't have anybody open to pass it to. Now Casper dumps it back in behind Cheveldae. Cheveldae one-handed. Yves Racine has it there. Intercepted, and the Lightning get back Crossman to break it up in the neutral zone. Now the Lightning make a change as the puck came right in front of their bench. 9 minutes remaining in the period. Here's a chance for Kontos. Good stop there by Cheveldae.
as Kantos picked up the loose puck. Probert looks to come out. He gets by Hartman. Three Red Wings into the Tampa Bay zone. Pass goes to Sheppard. Drops it back for Carson. Tried to go back to Sheppard on the give and go. Probert colliding behind the play with Adam Creighton. As well as Tucker. Bradley mishandled the puck momentarily. Now here's Tucker taking over again in the Detroit zone, but his pass was intercepted. And Fedorov will start it back for Detroit. Gets it off to Konstantinov again, joining the rush. Konstantinov sends it behind Bergeron. He backhands it up the board. Chiasson waiting there. Moves it back looking for Drake, intercepted by Chambers. Chambers just dumps it in wide to Chevalier. His
goal since December the 26th.
To tie the game at one.
I think that went between the feet of the goaltender. He's mad at himself. A little play from Gallant to Cicerelli. Coming around the back of the net. He pulls out in front. Got Crossman in the corner. Watch where this thing goes. Right between the feet. Bergeron misplayed it. And we got a tie hockey game. Ricky is there. We can't see the puck for 29 in the road. But Cicerelli ties the game.
Able to make something out of nothing. Puts the Red Wings in front 2-1.
Mark Fedorov didn't waste any time in letting this thing go. Ray Sheppard got it all going, plays it off the chest, ties up two Tampa Bay players. There's the quick move by Sergei and the snapshot right between the legs of Bergeron. I don't think he saw it. And Wings are on top 2-1. Carson will get the other assist. There's Sheppard staying with it, and when Chambers kicked it back, it was all over. Bing, bing. 2-1, Fedorov.
Is the call. Heisman drops it back. Chiasson drives the shot. Oh, look at Cicerelli. He is taking a pounding from Bergevin, and I think the two of them are going to go off, and Cicerelli really hot.
They're both going to go. One, but that's exactly what Tampa Bay had right there, and they played it perfectly. McCrimmon, the only guy back. The turnover at center ice, it's Lidstrom there at inside the line, rather. And Primo can't handle it. Kontos comes the other way. Hartman's going to be the guy, 23, that ends up with the goal. You see Chambers in the play. And Hartman made a perfect shot right into the top corner on the left side to tie this hockey game at two. A 4-on-1 break for the Tampa Bay Lightning. And we are tied.
Second goal of the season, number 23, Mike Hartman.
Second of the year for another one of the Detroit area players on the Tampa Bay team. I think it hit the goaltender, Mick.
It hit him in the head.
Yeah,
sure did. Hit him right in the head. Then climbed up a stick. There it goes. Bing.
McCray trying to strip it loose from Mercy. Rolls it in front. Good stop there by Chevalier and Tucker. Second time Tucker's had a great scoring chance in this hockey game and has nothing to show for it. 2-2 our score with 9:20 left in the second period. Lidstrom drops it back. Gallant picks it up. Backhands it to Yzerman. Yzerman back for Gallant. Chambers had that covered. Now Bradley. He's the leading goal scorer, and he gets by Racine. Bradley is in. Backhand shot at the side of the net. Boy, Bradley did a great job one-on-one against Racine, and then just didn't have enough left to get it over the top. Well, that by Probert. He lost his balance as he tried to clear the zone. They dump it back in on Chevalier. He steers it aside. It'll be picked up by Hartman. Hartman rolls it in front, went right through Howe's legs. Now picked up by the Lightning in front. Hartman snaps a shot. Good stop there by Chevalier. Probert knocks Creighton to the ice. That gets a reaction from the crowd. Rieke rolls it back in deep. Hartman. His pass intercepted by Howe, but Hartman gets it right back. Hartman, who has the goal to tie this game, rolls it to the crease. Tipped away along the board. Back in deep, Carson takes over for Detroit. Drops it back for Mark Howe. Now gives it out to Carson. Carson drives it deep into the Tampa Bay zone. Crossman gets there. Gives it off to Sander. First to speed into the Red Wing zone. Drop pass for Casper. Picked up. Here's Dan Cole with a chance. It was blocked by Konstantinov. Pass in front for Cole. Konstantinov
enough at him, and Chevalier covers before Casper can knock it loose. Seven.
Does it well. Dino slides down in front of the net. An easy cover for J.C. Bergeron, not Mark Bergevin.
So the defenseman, Sean Chambers. Been a hard luck season for Chambers, who had arthroscopic surgery on his knee back in October. Howe just trying to lift it into the zone. And look at that puck just jump right up. Oh, boy.
Not a chance to get out of the way at all. Right in the mouth, it looked like.
Yep. Yeah, Terry Crisp, always a pretty intense guy when he was in Calgary, Mick. And we talked to him a couple times that we've been down to Tampa Bay, and he really seems to have lightened up and enjoying things. I'm sure he still has the ability to get his message across to his players. But, of course, he played for a couple of expansion teams, Terry Crisp. Enrique, who just went down, hoping to block it. Wings may be caught here in a chain. Sandner, nice play to drop it for Danton Cole. Cole wants to go back to Sandner, but he couldn't get it to him. Now Cummins on the right wing side. 2 minutes left in the period. 2-2 our score. Eisenman flips it ahead, blocked by Taglianetti. He's dumped to the ice by Cummins. Kontos for the Lightning, drops it back now for Beers. Lead pass for Kontos, tipped away from him. McCrimmon able to go to Primo. Now Eisenman drives it ahead, in behind Bergeron. Taglianetti moved it quickly. Now Adam Creighton, number 10. For the Lightning into the Red Wing zone. Drop pass for Maltes. Maltes got by Konstantinov. Couldn't get much of a shot away, though. Chevalier stopped it. Maltes drives it into the wing zone. Eisenman gets a stick on it. It's recovered by Cummins. Wanted to go back to Eisenman. Chevalier's arguing. And I think some of the other Red Wings are saying that hit with a high stick.
Now Magoo's going to talk to the linesman. It was McCray that got the stick up and knocked it down. And it went down to the ice much like the Tucker goal, but it was much higher than the Tucker goal. And they will review this immediately. It is one of the reviewable plays. The puck knocked into the net with a high stick. And Magoo signaling to the players, just stay away, boys. I'm calling for a review. And the angle we've got, I'm not sure you can tell. Shot by Beers. No way you're going to tell on this one.
See, the key is where the stick is when it makes contact with the puck. You can start with your stick over shoulder level and then bring it down.
We'll see on this play. We should be able to, unless it's right up there by shoulder height. Looks from that angle right there that it's about chest high. And I'm not sure if it was McCray or the Tampa player in behind that got the deflection. The replay officials up to the right of us in the broadcast booth. Now on the phone with Mike Magoo. And they'll have replays that we don't have here to look at. So they'll see it from every possible angle.
So again, from that angle that we looked at, it looked like that the stick was around chest height when it made contact with the puck.
I'm not sure who was in behind McCray. He had his stick up around shoulder height while he was waiting for the puck to come in, but it looked like he lowered it as the puck got there and deflected it straight down. Is that Bradley standing in there? Right-hand shot.
It is.
See
a right-hand
shot.
Of
the screen. Now watch this. Watch the stick go up in the air here. See, the cameras are going off. There's McCray's stick. I'm not sure if McCray did get it dead. McCray's not over the shoulder, I don't think. I'm not sure they can tell who did deflect this puck.
Well, again, you mentioned they have some other angles, Mick.
That's true. From what we've seen, it's very, very difficult to tell. The other thing is that the question might be whether Magoo made the call or not as a goal or not.
Well, he called it a goal when it went in.
Did he?
Yes,
well,
he did.
He called it a goal.
It's got to be conclusive to overrule it.
That's right, and I don't think by looking at what we saw that it is, that they're really taking a long, hard look at it. It is a goal. They're going to center ice.
That'll be a power play goal. It took just 7 seconds off the Nick Lidstrom penalty.
And that was... And the original shot came through and hit Cicerelli right in the seat of the pants. But he was alert enough to go and pick up the rebound right there, give it to Yzerman. He comes out in front. Tampa Bay all gets tied up by Gallant. The two of them fall over each other. Bergeron's mistake. He goes down on his knees. And once he does that, number 19 has no problem putting it right into the top. There's a good look at it. No question about it. 3-3 hockey game.
32nd of the year for the Red Wing captain. And here comes Cicerelli. He drives a shot. Bergeron took a quick glance behind him. Divides him and it tied the game at 3 early in the third back after this. And he scores!
Well, Paul Eisenbach puts the Wings up in front of it. Steve Chazon made a great play. An onside pass to Eisenbach, hit him in the back of the tape. Bergeron gets a piece of this, but it got through him and trickles over the line to make it a 4-3 hockey game. But what a play by Chazon. Head up, he got the yell from Eisenbart. Cuts in, and just a little flipper. Pinballs off both pads and makes it 4-3.
17th of the year for the Rocket Man, who did not have a point in the last five games coming in. Well, the Rocket's been a little bit quiet. Here's a lead pass down for Maltese. Carson got back to take it away. Loose it front for Sandner. And he drove it right off the left pad of Chevalier. And now here's Carson. 5:47, so just 2 minutes and 7 seconds after the Yzerman goal. Eisenbart from Chazon and McCrimmon. And then the save on Maltese by Chevalier. Or rather, it was Sandner that drove the shot. Aglianetti sends it ahead. McRae tips it wide to Chevalier. Howe trying to move it back up the board. Burr gets it loose for Yzerman. Yzerman's got Racine coming late. Tried to drop it back for Shepard. Now Yzerman cross ice. Racine trying to get it in front. Again for Shepard. There. Ricky almost took Racine's head off, and then he retaliated, and Magoo only saw half of it, and that's
gonna,
what happens so often.
He's going to give it to him for roughing because Racine stuck the arm out. I thought for sure he was going to call double penalties there, one on each player. There's the hit by Racine. Nothing wrong with that at all.
No.
Nothing wrong with that. Now watch this exchange. There's the cross check, and Racine with the punch. He didn't see the cross check. He
Boy,
didn't see the punch.
That's hard to believe.
Awful call by Mike Magoo. 7:54 to go.
There's the penalty right there.
Boy,
they hit him with the glove. Hartman collapsed, not trying to draw the call. He did draw the call. That was a baby tap there.
Jeez.
Nothing much at all.
That was Tucker. Chevalier held his ground. Now Crossman tries to dump it in front, intercepted by Yzerman. He gets it to Sean Burr, who clears it down the ice.
That Tucker's had a six-pack of chances tonight, hasn't he?
Well,
he good
sure
ones.
He sure has. Now it comes to McRae. Takes out, bumps him, better out. Couldn't get it by Crossman. Now Crossman moves it deep to Bradley. Back to Crossman, quickly out to the line. Beers is there. Crossman, Lightning try to spread it out a little bit now. Bradley couldn't handle the pass. Wings got a break there. And it comes loose. Red Wings 3-on-2. Fedorov into the zone. Drops it for Eisenbart. Eisenbart goes back to Fedorov. Fedorov pokes it in front. Bergeron reached down and got it. Fedorov collides there with Adam Creighton. And we're down to 20 seconds left of the Kroger penalty. Crossman plays it ahead. Hartman had it patted away by Konstantinov.
Look at this.
Now it's knocked loose by Drake, and Bergeron will come out. He'll play it. He's able to send it all the way back down the ice. And the penalty to Probert has expired. Now Probert gets to the loose puck. It's in behind Chevalier. Back to Probert. Here comes Hartman. Robert lets it go for now.
Well, he should right now in a 4-3 game. They want the win more important than the payback.
Now McCrimmon, 5.5 remaining in the third. The linesman on the near side, Mick, was indicating.
Looking at the far guy, it looked like the puck had crossed center ice before Mikael Anderson did, but it's all for naught anyway as he doesn't get to the puck. Dumped up into the boards. 5-9 tied the game early in the third with a nice play.
Red Wings will play host to San Jose on Friday. We'll have that game for you right now. Bob Probert and a perfect shot just knocked the water bottles on top of that net behind Bergeron up in the air. You didn't need the red light to know it was in to make it 5-3.
Well, Ray Sheppard certainly picked the spot here. Right up under the bar. Good fake by Probert to hold on to it. Goes right to him. He got the little yell from Sheppard, and he goes up over the trapper next to that left arm. There's not much a goaltender. There's a great look at it there from behind the net. Good job, guys. And that is a shot there that if you put some zip on it, very few goaltenders are going to stop it. They can't get up there that quickly nor move their body sideways to stop it.
16th of the year for Ray Sheppard, Mick. Into his feet, couldn't make the play. He's about able to clear. Bergeron just got the right pad on that one. Now Beers trying to get through. Well, the Wings have it back. Eiserman tips it by Ricci. Eiserman pushes it ahead for Sean Burr. Burr one-on-one against Bradley. Burr trying to go back in behind the net with it. Eiserman with a couple of Lightning players out of there. Eiserman trying to dig it loose. He did momentarily. Now it's kicked away again by the Tampa Bay defenseman Beers. Eiserman again steps into him. Now Ricci plays it around. Konstantinov will hold it in. He'll drive a shot all the way through. That hit off the goalpost. Sounded like to the side of the net. Eiserman tried to snap it in front. John Bernow goes back to the... tried to go back to the point. He didn't get through to the German. Now Bradley carry it back. Intercepted. Here comes Carson. Carson across the line. Drives a shot. Now that's going to do it. The final seconds tick off the clock. And the Red Wings with 3 goals.
Will make him tired. It has an effect on the body overall, so he'll get somewhat weak. He may lose his appetite. Since some of the radiation is along the center of the chest, it may affect his esophagus for swallowing and may put him off his eating for a while.
It's an annoyance going through radiation for him. I mean, it's going to make him tired, but, you know, who cares about hockey at this point? You know, he's worried about his health and Mario Lemieux as a person.
All the guys talk to him. I mean, he feels fine, and well, he should. I mean, it was one of those things that a lot of people would never have even been diagnosed with at this point because he has the access to doctors so frequently that, you know, he noticed something was wrong and had it addressed a lot earlier than some other people might.
When he walked in, it was kind of shocked. We didn't know if we'd see him today or not, but it was great to see him, great to talk to him, because it kind of opens your eyes up a little bit and lets you know that, you know, everything's fine with him, so just, you know, go out and do the best you can, and he said we'll see you in a month.
The Penguins say Lemieux can return in 4 to 6 weeks, Mike, but several other doctors say it is more likely that he needs 2 months of radiation and recovery before he has the sufficient strength to play hockey again, so that would mean a mid-March comeback.
Scoring with 40 points in 46 games, and the center will solidify the Devils where they need it, down the middle. Patrick Division game at Madison Square Garden. Rangers and Washington Capitals, they always battle, and here comes Mark Messier into the glass. First period, Kevin Hatcher, one of his 3 goals. He had the hat trick on the night, and the Caps would take a 3-2 lead to the third. Rangers on the power play. 2 tries for Mike Gartner, second one past Jim Rivnak. That's John Van Beesbrouck, who would keep the game tied at 3. He was a stone wall. The Rangers are letting up too many shots. 52 shots let up on the night. Beeser turning away 48 of them. Still tied at 3. Adam Graves to Mark Messier, and he gets it past Rivnak, the one-timer. 1,200 career points now for Messier as the Rangers win 5-4. Both teams tied for second with 48 points. Every game in Hockey Wednesday, a division battle in the NARS. Tampered, second end of a home-and-home, and they're very familiar with each other. First period, Kevin Holler stopped by Frank Pietrangelo. Kirk Muller is not. 1-0 Habs. Then Eric Desjardins, 21 seconds later, 2-0 Habs. 28 seconds later, Desjardins tries again. He stopped by Brian Skrudlin on the rebound. 3-0. That was Brian Skrudlin. And that's Benoit Brunet. Nobody can be stopped on the night for the Whalers. Watch. They can't even stop themselves. Terry Yake put it into his own net. Hartford loses 7-3 with 40 games left. They're 20 points out of a playoff spot. In the NARS, Brett Hull scored in the first, but the Leafs scored 3 in the third.
And will miss anywhere from 5 days to 2 weeks. Barrasso flew back to Pittsburgh from Boston Thursday night, where the Pens played the Bruins. This one at Boston Garden. And Ken Reggett starting in goal for the Penguins and had a rough time. Bork the shot. Steve Hines deflects the puck past Reggett, and the Bruins are up 1-0 in a hurry. Second period, 3-0. Steve Hines in on Reggett and beats him. 4-0 Boston. In the third period, they were up 5-0. The Pens try and answer. Ron Francis stopped by John Blue. Final seconds of the game. The Bruins up 6-0. Reggett out of position. Hines gets the goal, the first career hat trick. John Blue gets his first career shutout. The Pens managing just 21 shots, their first shutout against Boston since 1977. The Kings and the Devils in New Jersey, the great one on hand, but really not much of a factor. First period, Devils up 2-1. Alexander Cimak beats Rob Stauber for his second goal of the game, 3-1 Devils. Second period, same score, Claude Lemieux with a slapper, and it's 4-1 Devils. Late second, 5-1 Scott Pellerin, the play of the day. That's another network, but you get the idea. He gets the goal, and it's worth another look. Pellerin falling, can't even see the puck, but knows what to do with the stick to get the goal. And the Devils hammer the Kings, 7-1. C-Mac's consecutive scoring streak extended to 10 games. He had two goals, also a pair for Claude Lemieux. The Devils with a 46-26 shots on goal advantage, and the rest of the NHL a little bit later.
We have Montreal and Quebec. They've met four times in the playoffs, each team winning twice, and 1-2 in the division. They could be in line for another playoff tangle. See what happens, but first of all, Thursday, there's Jacques Demers. As Montreal goes to Quebec City, Eric Desjardins beating Kirk Muller, beats Ron Hextall, 3-2 Montreal in the third. Then Stefan LeBeau is playing great hockey. Down the right wing, beats Hextall short side, 4-2 Habs. Patrick Waugh in the doghouse a little while ago, great play. Beat Andre Kovalenko, stopped him right there. Habs on the power play, 4-on-3. Off the missed shot, Vincent Domfus all over the rebound. The Habs win 5-3. They've won 5 of their last 6. Lead Quebec in the Adams by 5. In Chicago, Ed Belfour had 30 saves, nearly scored a goal.